final week home conference weekend series, get a sweep. It's also Mother's Day. It's also Seniors Day. Just reflect on all that today.
Just a really big weekend for us, especially because this is the last weekend series we'll play before going in, of course, the tournament. We wanted to dedicate this weekend to the seniors. Those six guys have meant a whole lot to us, and actually all six of them was part of that championship run last year, and hopefully we can duplicate it. But just all in all, I like the way we finished this weekend. I thought the pitching was superb. You can see our starting pitching start to come around, and then timely hitting. And then the defense, we're still working on it. So we still, you know, expecting to get that perfect game, play that perfect game where we put all three things together, you know, our pitching, our good defense, and then timely hitting. That's it. We're going to continue to work hard. You know, we're going to continue to work hard and see what happens. We don't have anything to lose. We got a very young ball club, but we're very capable of doing some big things.
Reflect on, recap on Friday, Saturday's game, man.
A pitching, starting pitching. You know, Southern University is still a very good ball club. They, you know, every time you play them, you know you're going to get pitched too well. The leader of that program, you know, it's all about tradition, and his kids play, you know. So by no means are we taking this weekend lightly. Friday ball game was a very close ball game. We did what it took to win. Yesterday ball game, I like the way we came back from a 3-0 deficit and then getting Alamo off the bench and then moving him over and then scoring the winning run. That was really big. And then today was all about Pearson, you know, Pearson and then a bunch of guys contributing, just a total team effort. And that's what it's going to take for TSU baseball to be successful.
Up to this point, has it been a roller coaster year? Or just
oh, absolutely, peaks and valleys. But all across the nation, you know, nobody is that's been consistent.
That's true.
You know, all across the nation, maybe one or two teams, but everybody's up and down, up and down, up and down. So we constantly remind our kids of that. But at times, you can see we show flashes, and you know, we put some good games together, but we just have to be consistent.
This is the first year since I've been covering that the bottom from 15 to 25, that group of schools have in and out of the rankings all year long, and some of them have actually fallen out. But it all boils down to a conference tournament, and everybody all over gets their shot.
It's anybody's ball game. It's anybody's ball game, and that's exactly what Division I wanted. They wanted parity, you know, in Division I, and that's what we have. It every year we have a team that's a Cinderella story, them and their program, their head coach and stuff. So that's not going to change this year. You know, who knows who's going to win it, you know. But nobody has been consistent all year long.
Is there anything else that has stood out this season or this weekend series that you can think of that I hadn't asked and all so far this season?
No, just our starting pitching. I feel that our starting pitching is starting to come together. We've always had, you know, Romero's been consistent, and then Rios came along slowly, so we had one and two. And now, look, Pearson has put together three good starts. So that's the thing I take out of, you know, going into the tournament and then ending this last weekend is that we had three solid starts. So we got three starters. So for me, that's good enough for us to, you know, get to the championship. Then we'll figure out how to win the championship, and hopefully we'll get there.
Just thought of two last questions. One, how has the growth been of this sport now up to this point?
The sport? You talking about the sport itself?
No, your freshman.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Look at OJ. OJ is probably going to get, you know, freshman All-American freshman of the year in conference. You know, OJ has put up some really good numbers. You know, Sanchez have, you know, showed some signs. You know, the future looks really bright, and we got four sophomores on the field. You got Blake, you got Dukes in center, you got Alamo at short, then LeBlanc at short. Both of those guys are sophomores, and then Amina is a sophomore. Yeah. So the future looks really, really, really bright for us. You know, we just have to put things together and see where this year takes us. We're not giving up by no means.
And one last, Tuesday, your last home game on this field this year. You got HBU. Yeah. Preview.
Yeah, an opportunity to beat a Southland Conference school. Actually, the school that won the conference, you know, last year. They won the Southland Conference.
That's so true.
Hopefully we can continue to use this game as a byproduct going in that game on Tuesday and then going into the tournament on the 18th.
All right. With that, Coach Michael Robinson of the Texas Southern Tigers baseball team. This is Jerry Lee Willie Jr., the College Sports Report. Thank you.
Thank you.